In order to see the general condition of the sealed unit, as well as the window, we need a photo of it. Tell us the type of structure of your window, either wood, PVC or plastic, or aluminum. When measuring a sealed unit, you must measure the width as well as the height of the glass surface in inches. If there are window grills in the sealed unit, you must identify the number of squares or quadrants. In this sealed unit, there are four squares or quadrants, one square or quadrant across the width, and four squares or quadrants across the height. To access the possibility of defogging a sealed unit, you must provide us with a photo of the sealed unit spacer at the bottom of the sealed unit. We can defog or replace glass only when there is visible fog between the two panes. For fog located outside or inside the house, on the pane, several factors can be involved, such as air circulation, ambient humidity, etc. For the identification of the correct model of mechanism or window crank, we must have a photo of the mechanism or crank with the window closed as well as open, so that we can clearly identify the mechanical system and correctly assess the problem, lock, crank, handle, etc. To check the condition of your window and door weather stripping, applying a light friction allows us to see the state of these weather strippings and if they've lost their flexibility or rigidity. Taking photos from several angles helps us understand what the problem is with a door that does not slide or open properly. A horizontal photo of the door, a photo of the rail, the mechanism, and the locking hardware allows us the opportunity to assist you correctly. Taking a photo of the four sides of the house allows us to check the number of doors, windows, and other openings requiring the application of sealer. To assess the state of deterioration of the caulking joints, photos of the caulking joints in close proximity can help with assessing the level of degradation.